Hey, what up, guys? This is Cody, and today I'm going to do my very first speaker verse video. Basically, it's going to be the Soundbox 2 versus two JBL PartyBox 110s, because one PartyBox 110 wouldn't be enough to keep up with the Soundbox in terms of loudness. But two is quite a bit loud. It's a bit louder than one, but still, they still struggle, even with two, to keep up with the Soundbox 2, because the Soundbox 2 is very loud. Now, in order for these top PartyBox 110s to have a chance against the Soundbox in the loudness category, is I got them both plugged in. So that should hopefully make it a fair fight. But they perform very differently, but I'm just gonna show you, or just show you of what they perform and stuff. And first, we're going to start off. Now, they're at 20% volume. Now, the Soundbox is going off of its own volume right here. I've got it down on the knob because I'm noticing that, well, I actually didn't notice this, but I never tried it that way, is that if you play the Soundbox by controlling it by the speaker on the volume on the speaker, it sounds a lot better than it would being controlling it from your phone. So that's what I'm noticing. But anyway, we're going to start, and I will throw in a dB meter. Because I did get a new dB meter for the cut, and I will show you. I'll show you the decibels once I reach 60% volume, and then and from here on out. But anyway, we're going to start. Song right here. I got two phones. Two of my old phones. That's my actual phone I use, and this is my older phone that I don't really use anymore. But that's the song right there, and we're gonna play this, and I'm going to show you the difference and how the PartyBox and the Soundbox perform. So first, we're gonna start off with the JBL PartyBox 110s, 20% volume. Oh yeah, by the way, bass boosted one is on on this thing, by the way. Soundbox 2. So you can see the Soundbox 2 is much quieter at 20% volume than the PartyBox are. But that will change once we get up to 40%. Soundbox is one of those speakers that starts off very low, but once it gets higher in volume, it goes really quick. JBL is very opposite, meaning it goes up very fast on the other end from 0 to 50, and then slower from 50 to 100. So yeah, the Soundbox is very quiet at 20%. Of course, this isn't the case if your phone volume was controlled, not the speaker volume. I definitely hear some bass. I definitely hear it. I don't feel the floor vibrating yet, and I don't feel the floor vibrating from the PartyBoxes yet either. But notice it's only 20% volume. Alright, now we're gonna play the JBL's We're going up to 40% volume. Because it's on the speaker. Oh, I cannot see. It's going to be good. Right, sound box at 40%. Here we go. Play the same song. JBLs are still louder at 40%, I'm not sure. Again, the volume is sound box. We haven't got to that part yet. To go to 60% volume now. Soundbox. Turn this to 60% volume. Here we go. 60% volume on the soundbox. We can find a way. Find another place where we can just stay. 80% on the party boxes.
Would I be better if I left it all behind? We could find a way, we could find a way. Find another place where we can just escape. We could find a way, we could find a way. Find another place where we can just escape.
Soundbox 80%. This is where it's gonna get really loud. Soundbox just increases by volume very quickly from here on out. There we go. 80% on the soundbox.
I've been trying to fight the demons in my mind. I'll prevail with every battle if I'm right. Guess my aim was off, the target's out of sight. Would I be better if I left it all behind?
Party box set 110s. Let's ride. JBLs. Now soundbox max volume. Crank it all the way up. Here we go. Soundbox 2 max volume. Here we go.
We can find a way.
soundbox is much louder than the Party Box 210s, 110s, even two of them plugged in. Still cannot compare it to the soundbox in terms of loudness. But the bass performance, the Party Box 110s are killing it. Like, I really love that deep bass. I could feel the floor literally vibrating. If not, I could slightly hear my cabinets vibrating, but I can barely hear them because the Party Box 110s are so loud. But the soundbox is not as impressive on that bass. It is very loud and it got good sound quality and stuff, but it's missing the bass. It only has bass, or at least some good bass, once you below half volume. Once you go beyond that, the highs and mids really overpower that bass. And it is what it is. But again, this is also indoors. It sounds different outdoor. I've tried it before and it sounds really deep good outdoor. But, and then the Party Boxes are really good for indoor because they sound really good indoor. Now they do sound good outdoor as well, but they do lose a little bit more bass outdoor than they do indoor because of the enclosed area. But yeah, that bass is incredible on the Party Boxes. It's crazy, and two of them especially. And I can feel the floor literally vibrating, and maybe I think I hear my cabinet rattling a little bit too, but. Yeah, guys, that's the JBL Partybox 110s, two of them plugged in up against the Soundbox 2, which is a battery power speaker. Now, the Soundbox 2 I paid $650 for, and then the JBL Partybox 110s, both of them were about $300, but one was $320, so I paid tax for it. But still, more than almost double, literally like double the price. Of the Party Boxes. The sound box is literally double the price of a sound Party Box. But again, those Party Boxes, I got them on sale. They're on sale. They actually retail for $400, but, and the sound box was a sale price as well, $650. It actually did retail when it came out at $900, but I think it went down to like $800 or $700. And at this point, I don't even think it's selling anymore because I don't see it anywhere online, including Amazon, where I bought mine at. But yeah, guys, that'll be it for this video. Don't forget to like the video, comment, and subscribe. And yeah, these two speakers are different, but if I had to prefer, if I had to choose which one in terms of sound performance, the JBLs literally did better, especially with the bass. I love the bass on the JBLs. They really are deep. And it's crazy. It's impressive for a battery powered speaker. Them JBLs will kick some ass, guys. I'm telling you. And them, they. I'm pretty sure JBL is the number one speaker performer in terms of like those battery powered ones, because they got a ton of bass. The soundbox is just cannot compare to the JBLs in the bass category. The only thing the soundbox can beat the JBLs with is overall loudness, but. And sound quality wise or distortion, none of these two speakers distorted. None of these speakers are distorted. The JBL or the soundbox had zero distortion at max volume, but the soundbox had really high treble. So, and then the JBLs had some good treble too, but not the best. But again, the bass is what I'm impressed about. It's that bass. That bass really gets you going, and I love that bass. It's a deep, heavy, soft bass, which I love. So yeah, in terms of sound performance, the Party Box wins, but in terms of overall loudness, the soundbox wins. So it all depends on which one you prefer, but a lot of people like bass, and them JBL Party Box 110s do not disappoint, especially when they're plugged in. They really have your wall. They literally can have your wall trembling, and I can feel the floor shaking a little bit from the bass, and they're not even touching the ground. They're not even on the ground. They're on that little thingamajigger. But yeah, I think I heard my cabinets rattling slightly too. But yeah, that'll be it for this video, guys. And like I said, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you in my next video.